What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another episode of the Survival Let's Play. And today is super special because I have a little bit of a tour for you guys. That's right, I finished the village. Now, I want to quickly thank all of you for all of your support building this. This was so much fun. I had a blast. All of you guys sent great ideas, and it was just a great time, and I had a super, super, super good time building this. So, I think, you guys, can you please be quiet for this? It's time to take a look at the villager village. So, this is it. I mean, I've done it. I think I've completed it. So here we go. We've got this gate right here. And if you want to know how to make this cool looking, a gate that's got different levels, well, if you attach a fence post to a cobblestone wall, it'll actually go lower, which is pretty cool. So that's how I got that effect, and I thought it made it look good enough, and the reason is I don't want these villagers to leave, and they can't actually open these gates, so that's a good way to keep them out. So, yeah, there we go, and also, mobs can't break these down, and they can't enter either, so props on that. So, inside of the village, we've got our mine. Now, this took a little while to get, because I needed to bring a silk pick. I can't speak today, can I? A silk pickaxe, and I had to get one, and I had to gather a little bit of gold. I got some iron and some lapis. I didn't get any diamonds or anything crazy just because, well, I wanted to keep all those. So I've got some gold, some iron, and a little bit of lapis up here, and that is the mine. Now, some villagers fell down here, and I don't think they can get out, so it looks like they're miners for life, which is kind of funny. So we'll leave it at that. I used mossy stone brick. Some of it's cracked, and you know what? I think it looks pretty good, so I'll definitely keep that the way it is. Now, over here, we've got this house. I know you guys have seen that. Over here, we've got this house. You guys have seen that, but right here, well, this is new, ain't it? This is a big tree. Now, you guys were asking for something in the center here. I thought a fountain would be cool. It just wasn't going to fit. It really just, I don't think a fountain would have been good, but this is small. It's small on the bottom, right? It's only, you know, 3 or 4 wide, but on the top, it really fills up the area. So that's the tree, guys. It's supposed to be like a dying oak tree or a big old super old oak tree. It's got lanterns hanging off some of the branches there just for lighting and decoration. We've got some mushrooms around the area, and I think it looks really, really good. Over here, oh, that's a little hole. Can I fix that? I can't. That's gonna annoy me. There we go. Okay, so, over here, I don't think I've done much else. You guys saw me decorate this house. We still got this guy in the cauldron, and you are just standing on that flower pot. You're really showing him. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah, so I've just added pathways, I've added a lot of bone meal to spice up the area, and really, I think I like it. Now, it doesn't really feel overpopulated as well. Usually, a lot of people are inside, and sometimes a few people walk outdoors, but I like it. I like it, and yes, and I don't know why these guys, they like the cauldrons a lot. But yeah, I'm really pleased, and also I'd like to show you guys that, yes, we finally have a completed tower. Now, I did complete it last episode, but the vines have finally reached the bottom, so we can actually climb up, and if you take a look, it's got a nice view vantage point of the whole village. Now, for some reason, for the life of me, I cannot seem to find that iron golem I made, and I brought him back in here too, which took forever. Did he abandon the village again? No, he's gotta be somewhere in here. How did he get out? I don't know. But anyways, you guys can let me know what you think. I personally really, really like this. This is definitely gonna be one of the places that I come back to a lot, just because of how good it looks. I'm really proud of this, guys. There are a lot of things that I would like to renovate in this world just because I don't think they look too good. And, well, I actually have an update on one of those things. Here we are, the all-new subscriber palace. You know what? I just didn't like the way it looked earlier. It just didn't look grand enough. Like, this roof came out, but there was no purpose of it. So I decided to save some quartz. I pushed the roof back. I turned the front two pillars into massive water fountains. And I added an arch archway above. I added, there's a little bit of gold up there, if you can see that. I added some more design, and I really just like the way this looks. And I also closed the back off so you can't see the sky through it anymore. And you know what? I think it looks really, really good. Now, it will, of course, see more renovations in the future, because I still think there are definitely ways to improve this, but I'm much happier with the way it looks now, and I think you guys hopefully will be as well. Now, I've also got a few subscribers to add while I'm here, so let me do that really quick. So, there they are, Acecraft Gaming, Daniel Rose, Shadow Fighter, and Shushbuckle Gaming. Thank you all very much for your comments. They were greatly appreciated, and thank you everyone for the support on this series so far. It has been absolutely magnificent. So, yes, I think that's just about it. I don't really have any other things to show you guys of, you know, of stuff I've done off camera, but there is one thing that oh, there he is! How did you get over here, dude? Yeah, okay, I don't have a lead, but once I get a lead, you are going back to your spot. You need to stop leaving. You're leaving those guys behind. They depend on you. And there's another one. That's the second one I made. They're both chilling over here. What is this, dude? Oh, I have a lead right here. One of you's coming with me. One of you's coming with me. So, the other build that I would really, really, really like to upgrade is, or change, is the hockey rink. And I think it just doesn't fit the theme of this whole place. And I know there are some things that are really out of place, like the Christmas tree. It just kind of looks goofy, but you know what? It's to celebrate Christmas. So, and the pumpkin too, although that actually kind of, sort of fits as much as it can for being a huge pumpkin. So, I don't know. We can see what kind of changes we can add to those places later, but for now, I'm gonna put some of this stuff away that I've got here, put Fish Dick back. He's been a while since he's been back here, so I'll give him a quick rest before we continue using him. And today, I think I'd like to take a break from building, because we've been working on that project for a while, and I actually haven't built in a few episodes, so I think it's time. No, I haven't explored. I've built the last, like, 6 episodes. Oh, yeah, and before I go, I know this may, like, sound like a weird jump cut, but here I just want to show you guys that that's the updated map. So if we take a look, the new things, well, we've got the potato farm and the carrot farm up there. We've also got the new village, which looks really cool. You can see the market, which is awesome, and you can see that little pond, too. So, yeah, I think it's pretty cool. I guess the next spot we need to go to make this whole place look a little bit better is maybe the jungle. I might have to do some stuff over by the jungle. Or back there, anyways. So, that'd be pretty cool. But until then, I think it's time we go on another journey. And this time, I wanna go through the Nether, and I'm not going to make another portal. I decided that, why not take a risk, and why not actually go, just go somewhere and see what we can find in the Nether. I mean, we haven't just walked around. I know I've been to a lot of places in this world, so it's gonna take a while to get far enough away to see new stuff, but I really want to find a new Nether fortress. Now, I can't guarantee we'll do it during this episode, and if we don't, I'll probably just think of something else to do to keep the episode entertaining, but for now, I wanna try, and I wanna try my best. And, okay, are you coming off? I don't want to hurt you. You got to get off of that. Are you good? No. Okay, can I push him off? I mean, I don't want you to push me off, so one of us has got to go, dude. Oh, you know what I could easily do? Sorry, pal. See you later. Oh, wow, that could have been bad. That could have been bad. What's up, dude? See ya. Okay. Oh, wow. I'm very, very glad I did not do that. So I don't actually have any cobblestone with me, which is probably a mistake. Let me just make sure. No ghasts. Oh, geez. This is very risky. Oh, this is very risky. We gotta go. Okay. We made it. Now, there's a lot of quartz here. And like I was going to say, there are a lot of benefits for just exploring. One, I need a lot more quartz. And with this Fortune 3 pick, I am going to get a whole lot. Also, we can get magma cream, which is something that I could use in potions. And of course, gas tiers, which are very hard to come by. So there are a lot of good side achievements. There are a lot of things we can do on the side. Alright, so it looks as if I've been this way, which is good, because I want to go to the farthest place I've explored, and then go farther. And the reason is because I need new generation to generate a new nether fortress, if I can find one, that has chests and all that extra glory inside. So, you know what? I guess it's time. We're just gonna follow these stones and see the farthest I went within the nether and push the limits and go even farther. Oh man, we are really far out. Like, I'm talking really far out. And I was hoping to see a few more magma cubes at this point, because I really like magma cream. Fire resistance potions are awesome. I didn't bring any with me, which is probably a mistake now that I'm thinking back. Oh my goodness, there are still drops here. There are still drops here from when I explored forever ago, just because I guess the trunks haven't loaded, I suppose. So that's kind of funny. Oh, wow. Did I really come I really came down here before. Holy cow. Guys, we are— oh my goodness, look at that! A golden sword, and it's still dripping. Oh, wow. Was I about to say dripping up and— I don't even know. Okay, well, it looks as if we can continue going this way. Oh, wow. Oh, this may be it, folks. This may actually be it. Oh wow, don't push me off, please. I think this might be it, unless I continued along this way. I think that— oh, I did. I think I just saw a cobblestone. Did I? Yeah, I did. Okay, I continued this way. Well, let's see what's over here. Well, folks, this is it. I mean, this is uncharted territory, so I have a few ways to go. I could go this way, but I believe back in this direction is the direction I came from generally, so what I'm gonna try to do here is, I think there's a ledge right down— yeah, okay, I can easily get down to this platform, and I see there's a lot more to explore over in that direction, so that is the area we are going to try to go to. I'm not too sure how easy this is going to be, and I don't know about this. I don't know about this. Okay, I guess we're doing it. No turning back now. So we're at the bottom, and I want to go ahead and mark this with wood. I was using cobblestone earlier, didn't bring any, but it's fine. Wood should be good. I know it'll bow. Wow. Okay. Well, maybe it's not as easy as I thought to get down here. Huh. Oh, you know what? It looks like that connect. I think I can do it. And would you look at that, we have. All right. So now that we're down at this level, oh my goodness, I have come so far. Still no magma cream though, man. And it kind of stinks. I haven't even killed any. That's a bummer. Well, I'm continuing on here, and I believe that we may find something of interest. Is this just a lava? It is just a lava pool, but it looks as if there's more land up there, and the higher you go, the easier— oh yeah, I think I can get over— oh, I can get over there. Perfect. So we got a little bit of climbing to do. Doesn't look to be too much though. We can easily do this, and then okay, jumped off there. I think, yeah, perfect. We can get up this way. Going to do a small— whoa, what was that? Where are you? Where are you? Oh, jeez. Thank you for not shooting me while I was on that hill though. Thank you, I appreciate that, buddy. But you're gonna die now. Oh, did that go through the lava? That might have. That might have done that, dude. I think I did. That was a championship shot, I'd say. Okay, he just interrupted my quartz mining session. Kind of rude of him, if you ask me, but that's fine. We can go ahead and finish that up. And I think, guys, we have a ton of new area to explore over this hill. Now, let's cross our fingers. Yes, it looks like there is more to explore. It looks like there is. Awesome. I just realized, if all else fails, I guess we can grab these mushrooms, because there's red and brown mushrooms here, so I have enough wood. We can easily— yeah, we could easily make a ton of mushroom stews, so that should be fine. Now, here we've run into— you know what this is? That looks to me— and this, and that? Oh, this looks like a— oh yeah, this is new generation and old generation right here. Awesome. I want to go to the new generation because, oh yeah, and there's also our first magma cream down there. Or excuse me, our first magma— what is it called? Magma slime? No, what is it called? What are you, sir? Magma slime? No, what's— magma cube, that's the word. But you give me magma cream, and I saw one of your partners just dropped. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. So this looks to be a combination of new and old generation, which is a little bit spooky, I'd say. Alright, so I found my way down, and I'm gonna continue exploring, and hopefully we can find something cool in this new area. Ladies and gentle fellas, I show you all the new Nether Fortress. Take a- What? Who? Who done it? Who- well, okay, and actually, seriously, what? Who? Who could have just shot me? What in the world? Oh, there you are, you numbnuts. You come on, stop shooting. Get out of here. Okay, you good? Did you leave now? See, guests, man. Right when I'm about to get them, they always leave. Well, as you can see, I have finally- Whoa, there's another one. That may have been the one that actually got me. Oh, okay. Oh my goodness. Yeah, okay. Disappear like that. Disappear like that one more time. See what happens. Oh, what? How did he just get hurt? Oh, come on now. Yeah, there we go. Whoop, bow. There, that's gotta be a hit. What? Dude, that just went through you. Okay. Oh, he's getting closer. There we go, and I took the damage, but I'm good. Let's see if he dropped a gas tier. Did he? Oh, no, that's a blaze spawner. He dropped a gas tier, though. It's so worth it. And I'm out. Oh my goodness, is that a wither skeleton? Dude! Are they hostile immediately? Yeah, they are. Oh my goodness, he is fast. Oh no, I'm in a heap of trouble. Look how fast this dude is. Okay, so he died. And we grab his bones. We've got the other ghast back. Dude, stop it. Jeez, oh my goodness, and these guys too. Oh no. Oh, we got another one. Oh jeez. Okay, dude, relax. Where did you even come from? Whoa, what did he just drop? Oh, coal, that's pretty cool. Okay. I need shelter, and shelter is easiest way. Now, did this ghast drop any ghast tears by chance? Doesn't look like it. Into the shelter we go. Now, this way and this way look like they may be dead ends. Okay, well, let's... Oh, that's a dead end, too. Wow. Anti-club. Whoa, what are you up to over there, dude? Is that a wither... Look at his armor. Look at that wither skeleton. He's a tank. Let's get down there. What's up, dude? Now, he may actually take a few shots. Look at that armor. He's still running away. Are you running away, dude? No, there he is. Wow. Oh my goodness. He actually took a ton of damage there. Now, what do you have on those nice little pantaloons? Protection 2, not too bad. Okay. Well, we're down here now at another level. Looks to be completely different, so there may be some stuff over here. Uh-oh, we're down in the blaze level. Okay, so I think that right up there is where I entered, so I may just want to sprint undercover. Okay, that's the blaze spawner right there. There's nothing over there. Let's go this way. Oh, there we go. I think we're safe. I mean, those blazes, they're not too bad, but if you get trapped, man. Oh, man, are they dangerous. Okay, ooh, the lava room. Is there nether wart nearby? I would like to get a little bit of nether wart. That would be very cool. Now, I know this is definitely near a chest. I know chests are in areas that look similar to this. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That goes down really far. Okay, let me explore some of this first. I see nothing over here. What about over here? Oh, there's the nether wart. See, I told you we're close to nether. Oh, a chest. Our first. Oh, geez. Even bigger problem. Is he good? Oh, geez. Okay. Oh. Is he dead? I can't tell. No, he's not. He just kind of chilled there. Okay, there we go. Now he's dead. There's a wither skeleton down this hallway too, and another blaze. Oh my goodness, this is ridiculous. So there must be a spawner nearby, right? Right? No. Okay, there's another chest over here. Oh, baby. Oh, that guy's got an enchanted sword. Pretty cool. Okay, so let's check out what is inside of this here chest. Let's see. Oh, wow, three diamonds and a saddle. I can take that. Let me go ahead and give the gunpowder back and some of this extra blockage that I do not need, and we'll run back on over to the other chest. So here we are, and shall we? Oh wow, gold horse armor and a gold ingot. You know, I don't really need that. That's just gonna take up inventory space, but we do have gold horse armor, which is awesome because it's uncraftable, so that is good. I will also grab all of this here nether wart. We will just take it all today, and we'll leave it at that. And is there stuff? Oh, there's more back there as well. Choices. Let's go right, and we'll see what is down this way. Although it looks like most of this is probably going to be a dead end. Oh, maybe not. This actually goes some, whoa. Is there another? Is that another build? There's another building up there. Okay. This definitely does come to a dead end, so we'll pick another way. Well, those all led to dead ends, so a little bit of a bummer, but we can go up here, and that looks like it's gonna take me to a whole new area. So we can go ahead and grab some of this netherrack, and it doesn't look like we could go that way. So, phew, new. Oh, wow. Okay, there's a blaze over there. Oh, and a chest right here. Well, first things first, let me munch on some bread, and we'll deal with that blaze over there in that. Oh, and there's another chest. Wow, wow, wow. Okay, this one has gold horse armor again, and three diamonds, so we're up to 6 diamonds on this trip, which is super cool. And if we go over in this direction, it looks as if there's another chest, and then this probably leads to a dead end. Yeah, it does. Okay, so let's check out this chest. 2 diamonds in a saddle. Man, we are getting so lucky with these diamonds. That is so awesome. Okay, so let's take a look down this hallway. Doesn't look like there will be much down here, but we can take a peek. Nope, nothing. Nothing, nada. All right, now comes the real challenge. Where is this blaze is? We got to get the blaze first to make sure he does not hurt me. And there we go. Got him down. That was easy. That was pretty easy for a blaze. So we run back over here. There's an upstairs, but this may go somewhere as well. No. No, it won't. So there we go, we're up to 40 nether wart, and that's good. And I know I have a nether wart farm, that's no surprise, that's no secret either, but you know what, it's always good to have, and my nether wart farm is pretty small, so I can use as much as I can get. So there we go, I think I've explored this way, and if you remember, there is a lot more to explore just around the way. I think we saw an area where there were like 3 stair sets in a row. I think that's right over here, is it? Yeah, okay. Okay, so at the bottom of the steps, there is a, ooh, pigman with an enchanted sword, but and more importantly, there is a chest with iron horse armor, a flint and steel, which I don't really need, and another saddle, which I will gladly take, and then over here, it looks to be just a dead end. So 3 sets of stairs for nothing except the chest, which isn't bad, but you would expect all of this staircase to lead to some more temple, but I guess not. So what is that right? Oh, that was a torch. Yeah, that was a torch. Okay, let's head back. So a new direction of this temple to explore. I think, yeah, okay, that's where we just were, but it looks as if there may be something. Now this is screaming dead end to me. It is. Oh, and it also has a bat. Oh, no, it's not. Let me go ahead and make sure that blew up. Okay, I think we can go this way. Yeah, okay, so this is taking me on top. Can't really get around that too easily, though. Oh, I could use some of this netherrack. Good, good, good. Use my resources. Oh, gosh. Blaze spawner, blaze spawner, blaze spawner. We are out, we are out, we are out, we are out. Oh, my goodness. They just missed my head. They almost shaved me. Okay, I think down here is where I need to go. Right this way. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, this is, I can go back to where I was. Ah, ha, ha, perfect. So, the only direction I have not explored is this way, and I believe this looks to be a dead end. So, you know what? I would say that was a pretty successful journey around this whole temple here. So let me run over here and see what this is all about. I know, yeah, okay, I've been over here. That's where the wither skeleton was. Okay, you know what? This may be a safe way to actually get back to where I started because I've gotten everything I need. There's already a nether fortress, near my base. So I'm not too worried about keeping this for the spawners, but yeah, so I just explored the whole entire fortress, and we're back at the start. So, I mean, mission accomplished. We ended up with 3 sets of horse armor, 2 gold and 1 iron. We got 2 saddles and a few diamonds, and I really come to these places for the horse armor just because you can't get that anywhere else. So I would say today was a rather successful exploration episode. Now, it's time to head back home. Well, ladies and gents, I can add new saddles and new horse armor into the chest of horse goodies, and I'd say that's a pretty proud moment, so I'm very pleased with that. Oh, and I also, whoa, whoa, whoa! Oh, never mind. I did only get 3. Okay, just checking. Just checking. So yeah, today's episode of Exploration, I would say, was pretty fun. I mean, I had a great time exploring and risking a little bit of my skin to try to find an awesome nether fortress. So I'm pleased. Hopefully you guys had some fun as well. And I think that's enough explanation for me, though. I think I'm ready to go back to building. Because I got pretty spooked out. I was going to lose all my stuff. And they're still over there. Dude. Come on. So, with that being said, I think we can put these extra diamonds away, put some of our armor away. Where do I keep my, that's the armor chest. There we go. Put some of this away. And, I got some nether stuff that I can put away, a ghast here, that can go in my brewing room. So, yeah, I mean, today was really successful. Thank you for watching, and you know what? Hopefully you liked the change of pace and, the exploration episode. We'll continue on, doing some more, creation later on, but I thought it was a good break. So, now, our low supply of nether wart has just doubled, and I'll make a bigger farm maybe later. I also have one more magma cream. So, I definitely need a lot more of that. That was kind of pathetic. And one ghast here, which I don't have a lot of anyway, and you really can't get a lot of just because of how hard they are to get. So, our collection grows slightly, which is always good. It's always good. Anyways, to check up on the other farms, I mean, this is still running good. It's not automatic, though. I want to check the automatic farms. I haven't been over here in a while, so I doubt they have the... Oh, wow, that's a lot of cactus. Surprise, that's a lot of cactus. That's pretty good. Those are not automatic. Is the beet? No, that can't be automatic either. So the only other completely automatic farm we've got is is this one over here. So we can take a look and see how good our sugarcane is doing. And it's doing decent. Definitely doing decent. So, can't complain at all. Well, folks, I would say that just about wraps up today's episode. Thank you all so much for watching. And as always, stay frosty, my friends. Peace, guys. See ya. Bye-bye.